Social researcher Mark McCrindle joins us now. Mark, our population is absolutely booming. What does it, that sort of actually mean for everyday Australians as we look to the future?
Well, it's going to continue to boom. We're actually adding about 1 million people every 2 years, and we're the fastest growing developed nation on the planet at the moment. So in 20 years' time, we'll have an extra 10 million people, another 3 million households. It definitely has some benefits. Australians say that diversity has enriched lifestyles. It gives us a scale where we can get some shopping and entertainment options, transit options that otherwise we wouldn't have. But we do see the pain of this, the rising house prices, the traffic chaos, just the waiting list for public services. So there's a downside to it.
Okay, by 2034, there's going to be 33 million of us. Where are you going to put us all, Mark? Where are we going to live?
Well, we're seeing already the increasing housing density. And so people living up and not just out end of the suburban sprawl to some extent. But if we look at the trends, the way we've grown our country is not by planting new cities, but by growing our existing ones. So we're going to see more of that.
So we're sort of looking almost at that Asian model. So, you know, you're driving out of Hong Kong and you're driving for 20 Ks and there's just those huge buildings with thousands and thousands of people. Is that sort of thing?
Yeah, not the extent of that, but definitely that's the pathway. I mean, we've actually got, as a nation, one of the lowest densities on the planet, with 7.7 million square kilometres and 23 million people. But our cities have amongst the highest densities, just because we live in our cities, not the rest of the landmass, and that will continue to happen.
Okay, there's talk of the elderly community downsizing in order to accommodate these changes. What are we looking at there?
Yeah, we've got an ageing population, and so over the last 30 years, we've increased the number of 85s by more than fivefold, or almost fivefold. So we're living longer. I mean, that's a good news story, but it means that the households will change and there's not going to be the capacity to look after all of our elderly in facilities and institutions. They'll want to stay at home, ageing at home. We're going to see, therefore, multi-generational households with mum and dad and the kids and their parents under the one roof.
The Aussie quarter acre dream, that's just not a concept our kids are even going to talk about or know about, right? It's
that's
just not
right.
going to be a thing.
In fact, the average new land release block in Australia is 1/10 of an acre, 423 square metres, so a long way from the 1,000 square metres of old. And of course, new housing is more in the medium and high density. So the shed is a thing of the past, the hills hoist, cricket in the backyard.
Yeah, I was going to say backyard cricket and the slippery slide thing.
the slippery slide.
Yeah,
absolutely.
Yeah.
Shampoo on that and then going off into the... when you kept going at the end of the grass.
Oh, did you always shampoo? We're only allowed, like, the palm olive, the dishwashing liquid. You had shampoo.
Yeah, but I pinched it from the store.
This is interesting. Single women, 50 and over, the fastest growing type of household in Australia. So I guess in that case you're looking at women who are divorced.
Well, that's right. I mean, you've also got growth in the solo person household. So a lot of people living longer and living alone for longer. But just changes.
How's that going to change in the next sort of
We've actually been on this trend of smaller households for actually a century. We had 4.6 people per household 100 years ago. Now we're at 2.6, but it's just turned the corner. And we've got slightly larger households now. Not that we're having more kids, but just that we've got more people under the one roof because of housing affordability challenges.
Fascinating stuff, isn't it? Finally, Australia's suffering a skills shortage, but the number of people working set to increase. So what's the workforce look like in the next decade or two?
Well, actually, we're going to have older workers. We've got a bit of a challenge because the population is growing. We've even got a baby boom and people living longer. Yeah. But the working age proportion isn't keeping pace with that population growth. So now we've got about 5 people for every retiree. In 40 years' time, we'll have about half what we have, about 2.7 people of working age for every retiree. So people will work later than we currently have and work perhaps longer in a lot of ways.
Doesn't really suit me. How about you?
It doesn't suit me. I still want to go back to being a kid with zinc on my nose and a terry toweling hat on my head.
Yeah, absolutely. You would look really, really cute with that terry toweling.
I did. Thank you, Mark. It's fascinating stuff, isn't it?
And don't we love those old pictures? Okay. Thank you, mate.